I'm here with Myron Vernis, and he has an unusual car. I thought it was a DKW from the 30s. I thought it was maybe an Audi or an Auto Union, because I know the Europeans, Hans Ludwinka and Paul Jouret, they're all doing this aerodynamic stuff. And I thought, oh, that must be one of their concept cars, but that's not what it is at all. Tell people what it is.
It's the 1935 Hoffman X8. Rod Hoffman was a journeyman engineer in Detroit, and this is just his ultimate design.
So this is the only one he built?
It's the only one.
Okay, so it's a limited run.
Yeah. If you see it, it's original.
You know, it looks like a production car. What year is it? 1935. Okay, so obviously he was into aerodynamics. And tell us about the engine.
The engine is an X configuration 8-cylinder engine, a narrow angle.
Yeah.
X8, about 60 degree.
Like a bunch of Harleys.
Four Harleys put together, or two V4s laid on their side.
Wow, and the transmission?
On a central crank. The transmission, we don't know. We haven't been in the transmission. Everything's one off. Transmission, differential, and clutch.
Okay. So he made the whole thing?
The whole thing.
Gee.
Yeah.
And did he hope to go into production? Did he just build it for himself?
Well, the story is that he was supposedly under contract to the Fisher brothers, who at the time were thinking about buying the Hudson Motor Company, and this was going to be their new Supreme model.
Right, right. Well, you know, the fascinating thing about Pebble Beach is, I don't care how big a car enthusiast you are, whatever you think you know, you come here and you find something you've never heard of or seen before. And how did you come about this?
You know, I feel really blessed to have the car through good friends. This car, Hoffman kept the car till 1961 when he gave it to his good friend, Brooks Stevens.
Oh, Brooks Stevens, okay.
And they worked together. They met in 1951 when they were working on a project called the Paxton.
Yes, yes, which you have.
Which I purchased several years ago from the Brooks Stevens collection.
Right, right.
And they gave it to Brooks Stevens. Well, this is the one car the family kept out of the collection when they dispersed the museum. And I had been dropping hints with the family over the years that I'd love to have it, and they were kind enough to call me about a year or so.
You know, it's fascinating. When I saw it drive in this morning, I thought it was a car that had been restored. But is this pretty much original?
It's all original, except for one thing. The paint is not original.
Okay.
Brooks Stevens, who was a great designer, had a rule. If he owned a car, it was closed, it had to be Packard blue. If it was open, it had to be Packard green with black accents.
Really?
So he, of course, when he got the car, he had
And what color was it originally?
It's a gunmetal gray, the dash, the door jams.
Right, right. Can we open the door? Show us what we have here. Here we go. And
all original interior, 3-speed manual on the dash.
Look where the gear shift lever comes out of the dashboard. Bit of a circuitous route to the back there, isn't it?
The monkey motion and the lever are crazy.
Let's open the engine compartment and show people what we're talking about here. It looks very German. It looks very 30s.
Well, his name was Hoffman.
Yeah,
and he was American.
Okay.
X8. Again, two V4s laid on their sides.
Right.
Water-cooled overhead valve engine. The differential is cast into the same, the differential housing is cast in the same as the engine block.
So he cast the block and everything?
Everything, yeah.
Jeez. Now, this looks like it might have been a Cord, a L29. Transmission adapted to this. Am I way off base? What do you think?
I don't know. You know, we haven't been able to verify anything.
And the way this drives, blowing at this, you're going down the road. I guess it's pulling air in and force.
It's an exhaust. It blows the other
way. Oh, it pulls it through.
Right.
Okay, I see. Because logically, it seems like the fan should be on the other side.
One thing in working, and Lynn Smith and I have been laboring on this car for the last 3 weeks just to get it going. Every logical assumption we made about the car, we were absolutely wrong.
Wow. Well, it's got low center of gravity. It must handle pretty well,
and
huh?
It's mid-engine, because the engine is in front of the differential.
Yeah, wow. It almost looks Tatra-ish. Well, what a fascinating piece of engineering. And is anybody from Hoffman's family still around?
Unfortunately, no. Yeah. I've spoken with three people who've written about him, who knew him, and they all said, great guy, would never talk about the car. Promised
really?
His investors he would never talk about the car.
Why? Even though he had no investors after, okay.
Yeah.
And, wow. Was he a successful man?
Did he he did a lot of, he had a very successful engineering firm in Detroit, worked for a lot of the manufacturers.
Wow. I imagine it's 6-volt, correct?
6-volt.
Can we hear what this, well, it's not a V8, it's an X8.
It's an X8,
Let's hear what an X8 sounds like.
The only X8 in the world.
Wow. Wow. Amazing. And she cools all right?
Cools beautifully, yeah. And the heads are funny because they're they're actually Siamese for about an inch, mm-hmm. so they're not totally separate.
Yeah, yeah. And it's obviously a two-valver, right?
It's a two-valve, overhead valve,
and
twin cam, push rod.
Wow. You know, we always think of American automobiles at this period as being a little boring. It always seemed like the exciting stuff was happening in Europe, but it's amazing how many guys, independently of the majors, we're just doing this type of work. I mean, this looks like a production automobile.
Yeah,
it's amazing.
The body is all steel. You know, it wasn't a prototype that would be hand hammered out of aluminum. It's all steel. So obviously there were dies for the body made.
Right. And where was this? Detroit?
We believe the car. He was from Detroit. We believe the car was made in Boston.
Oh, in Boston? Oh, I'm from Boston. I never heard about this. See, this is what I love about Pebble Beach. I never heard about this car. Wow, this is fascinating. Well, you know, you have to do a book or something on this.
Well, we're trying to find someone who knows some history on it. Hopefully by bringing it to Pebble Beach, we'll find some people that might have some more.
If you know any, talk to your grandfather or somebody. If they know anything about this car, let us know. Hey, thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Myron, really, thank you for saving this wonderful piece of history.
Well, thanks to Stevens family for pulling it out.